In the 1970s, the U.S. government commissioned a group of 100 freelance photographers to document life in the U.S., with a particular focus on the environment and on the pollution and waste that ended up in our rivers and streams and lakes. These photos captured the unregulated dumping of industrial waste into these waters, marring their natural beauty. It helped the public see what a serious problem water had become in the U.S., and show why one of the country's first environmental laws in 1972 was the Clean Water Act, a law that gave federal protection to U.S. waterways from pollution from industries like mining, oil and gas extraction, real estate developers, municipal waste agencies, and agriculture. But the U.S. has millions of miles of waterways, in which specific waterways get this protection has been a major source of disagreement between the past two presidents. And nowhere is this disagreement felt more than in the state of New Mexico.
We need everything we have in our power to protect our water for drinking, for habitat, and really for growing food. And as we say here in New Mexico, el agua es vida, water is life.
This is a map of the rivers that run through New Mexico.
The Rio Grande is the main artery of New Mexico. Many people depend on it for drinking water, for irrigation, for recreation, and for spiritual values.
Behind me is the Rio Fernando. It starts in the Carson National Forest, and it comes down all the way through the town of Taos, and it continues through the valleys where food is grown, and it meets up with the Rio Pueblo, which then eventually spills into the Rio Grande. It's an important river for birding, for habitat, for irrigation, for our farms, and for drinking water too, for the town of Taos.
We are sitting alongside the Santa Fe River in the city of Santa Fe. Santa Fe River is basically the lifeblood of northern New Mexico. It is a source of drinking water for over 80,000 people.
On a map, these rivers all look like blue lines. But in real life, they have some major differences. Some are perennial, meaning they flow year-round, all the time. That describes the Rio Grande River. Some are ephemeral, meaning they flow as the result of precipitation, or intermittent, meaning they only flow for part of the year. The Santa Fe River and the Rio Fernando River are both combinations of these two types. Most major rivers in the U.S. are perennial, but some regions, like the arid American West, have a lot more ephemeral and intermittent water sources than perennial.
A lot of our river flow is dependent on snowmelt and to a lesser degree our monsoon rains that come in the summer.
These water types are basic ecological markers that help scientists classify streams and rivers. But over the past several years, they've become a political distinction that determines what gets protected and what doesn't. After the Clean Water Act went into effect in 1972, the assumption was that waters of the United States, although vague, meant all types of water would be protected. And it made it a prosecutable offense for industries to pollute or degrade waterways unless they got explicit permission through a permit. But a pair of Supreme Court cases in 2001 and 2006, brought by real estate developers and municipal waste agencies, started making exceptions for which water bodies could be protected, like some wetlands and ponds. This stripping of protections prompted the Obama administration in 2015 to release this massive 400-page report based on 1,200 peer-reviewed studies on how watersheds work. The report laid out something important about how these types of water sources interact with each other in a watershed like this, where a perennial water source may be a primary waterway, but ephemeral and intermittent streams and rivers feed into it. And surrounding wetlands are either connected on the surface through flooding or under the surface through groundwater. This whole watershed acts like a sponge, expanding and contracting with the volume of water and sharing organisms, nutrients, and pollutants. Basically, the different types of waterways are all connected.
And if you dump pollution in one part of a system, it will eventually make its way to other parts.
This report informed the Obama administration's Clean Water Rule, which established that all of these waters should be protected under the Clean Water Act because they promote the health of all water. But in 2020, to appease industry leaders, the Trump administration finalized a rule that reversed Obama's clean water rule and excluded intermittent, ephemeral, and isolated wetlands from federal protection.
The dirty water rule is so much easier to call it that because it is taking away 90% of the protections in New Mexico.
Trump's ruling means that there's no more federal protection for more than 2 million miles of U.S. rivers and streams, which ultimately flow into other water bodies, as well as more than half of all remaining wetlands in the country, roughly 56 million acres. Water bodies that help prevent flooding and serve as a wildlife habitat for migrating birds. And because there's no penalty for polluters in these waters, it means that the cost of cleaning up pollution will now fall on local and state governments.
This is an affront to every single county commissioner throughout the United States who has to clean their water. The more money they have to spend on cleaning their water, the more taxes they have to raise to take care of their constituents.
Some states lose more protection than others, like in northern New Mexico, where a watershed like this one lost protection on more than 55% of its wetland acres and 63% of its protection of streams and rivers. And across the state, up to 90% of waterways lost protection because of this new rule.
So when those federal protections are taken away, we do not have a state structure or regulation in place to fill that gap. And that leaves our waters really at risk to unregulated dumping in the wake of this rule.
Lots and lots of threatened and endangered birds live here on this property and all up and down the Rio Fernando.
It is a devastating impact to our community, to New Mexico.
The fate of which waterways get protection under the Clean Water Act now lies with the Biden administration, which is likely to overturn the Trump administration rule and revert back to the stricter protections from the Obama era, based on the science of the 2015 Water Report. But that won't be without a legal fight from the industries that have a lot to gain from looser protections.
The dirty water rule was supported by polluters, and I imagine that they're going to fight to ensure that this rule makes it into the next administration's priorities.
We've worked so hard since the 1970s to clean up our rivers. It's just a shame to take these steps backwards in protecting our nation's waters.